Dervish, calling yourself a lover. With God's love do you not whirl around? With his love do you not travel the 18,000 worlds? Then take the floor and whirl with his love. Address him with love, call on him with love. As for the dervishes, who are true lovers, while their hands are at work, their hearts are with their beloved. Whatever job they do, whatever their business may be, it never distracts them from remembrance of God. Their eyes are tearful with longing for the divine vision. Their hearts are seared by divine love. The eyes of the dervishes who are true lovers see nothing but God. Their hearts know nothing but Him. God is the eye by which they see, the hand which they hold, the tongue with which they speak. The dervishes are children of the moment. They are ready to renounce renunciation. The dervish's litany is the illustrious name of Allah. The dervish does not stop at the names, but discovers the named and surrenders to his beloved. The dervishes have no worries and no cares. Their sole concern is God. Their pain is God. Their remedy is God. Their cure is God. Their cause is God. Were they not in love, they would pass away. If their heart should be devoid of love for as much as a single moment, the dervishes could not stay alive. Love is the dervish's life, their health, their comfort. Love ruins the dervish, makes him weak. Holy union makes him flourish, brings him to life. Love makes us speak. Love makes us moan. Love makes us die. Love brings us to life. Love makes us drunk and bewildered. It sometimes makes one a king. Love and the lover have no rigid doctrine. Whichever direction the lover takes, he turns toward his beloved. Wherever he may be, he is with his beloved. Wherever he goes with his beloved. He cannot do anything, cannot survive for one moment even without his beloved. He constantly recalls his beloved, as his beloved remembers him. Lover and beloved, rememberer and remembered, are ever in each other's company, always together. A person often remembers the object of his love. One who is a lover of God, exalted is he, also remembers God, always and everywhere. This is the duty and proof of love. This much does love demand. Love brings the servant near to God, glorified and exalted is he. Love reminds the servant of his holy servitude and increases his devotion. Love removes vanity and hypocrisy, increases truthfulness and sincerity. Love solves all problems, opens all closed doors. For love's sake, the sky has been raised up and the earth has been spread out. For love's sake, the universe has been created and adorned. Love makes us cross the deserts. Love makes the traveling easy. Love overturns the mountains, smooths out all obstacles. Love illumines the heart and delights the mind. Love causes neither sleep nor hunger nor thirst. Love simply makes us weep. Love makes us speak. Love makes us moan. Love makes us hear. It is love that creates all the fine arts. Everything is brought into being and created for the sake of love. The whole universe, being itself and creation, began with love. With love they should rightly end. Everything in the universe is doomed to pass away, but love is everlasting. The bearers of the holy throne hold up the throne with love. All the angels in the heavens congratulate one another in celebration of the divine love. All the stairs of the gardens of paradise, adorned for love's sake, have been raised aloft with love. In heaven, love. On earth, love. To the right, love. To the left, love. Everywhere and everything is love. Love is God. The lover is God. The beloved is God. The loved one is God. The dear one is God. The friend is God. Love your beloved, for the beloved is God. Love your own true self, for your own true self is also God. This is Lex Hixon, and the luminous words you just heard were those written by Shaykh Muzaffer Effendi in his new book called The Unveiling of Love, and we have the author here in the studio with us. The Shaykh is visiting from Istanbul with his dervishes, and he's visiting his beloved New York City. He actually has fallen in love with our country and with the American people, and he wrote this book, which is his first book to appear in English out of extensive Turkish writings. He wrote this book for the American people and to invite them to the path of love. And we're going to ask him some questions about that this evening. There has been a mosque and dervish meeting house built and dedicated to Sheikh Muzaffer's order, the Jerrahi order of dervishes, which is down in Soho. And the Sheikh will be meeting people there for the last time to bid farewell for this trip on Thursday evening, and again on Friday afternoon at 3 o'clock, when he'll be answering questions. That mosque is at 155 Mercer Street. I'll mention again at the end of the program the address. And the Unveiling of Love, which I deeply recommend to you all as an incredible book, was published by Inner Traditions, a very bright new publishing house, which is concentrating on the very finest esoteric teachings, ancient and modern. And it's available in places like Wiser's and East-West Books in Manhattan. But for many of you who are listening from outside Manhattan, a book service called Community Books has this book in stock, and you can call them and do it by mail or telephone. And I'll give the number now just to get it over with, and then again at the end of the program. The number for Community Books is 543-5530. 543-5530. The Sheikh will be speaking in Turkish, and the English interpretation will be given by our dear friend Tosin Bayrak, who is also a Sheikh in the order and who is the representative of Sheikh Muzaffer here in this country. And Tosin has lived with us in this country for over 20 years, and he's pretty aware of our idioms and our ways of thinking. So he's very prepared to kind of make a very meaningful translation, so you really feel that the Sheikh is speaking directly to you, which he definitely is. Tosin, the question I wanted to ask Effendi concerns how the path of love, how Islam, seen as the path of love, understood in, as the path of love, is rooted in the character and life of the beloved Prophet Muhammad. And many people in the West, with very incomplete information and without having the richness of the Islamic upbringing, haven't understood this beloved prophet as a person of love. You can shorten this question any way you want to, but I'd like to know what was the beloved prophet like? What how did he live, and how did he express love in his life?
Olduğunu Hazreti Peygamber sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem Efendimizin hayatından nasıl öğreniriz? Kendisini bize tanıtır mısınız bu şekilde diyor. Çünkü bazı yanlış fikirler var diyor. Bu yanlış fikirlerin, İslamiyet'i bilmeyenlerin yanlış fikirlerinin düzeltilmesi için bunu sizden rica ediyorum.
Evet. Cenab-ı Hak levlak levlak lema halakul eflak, yani seni yaratmasaydım, eflakı yaratmazdım, felekiyatı, yani cihanı yaratmazdım buyurmaktadır.
God Most High says levlak levlak lema halakul eflak. If I would not have created you, I would not have created the creation.
He says this to the Prophet Muhammad?
Yes.
Yine hadis-i kursiyede ben gizli bir hazineydim. Kendimi bildirilmek bana sevdirildi ve ben mahlukatı halk ettim buyurmaktadır.
Again, in another hadith, tradition of the Prophet, Allah says that I was a hidden treasure, that it became lovable for me to let myself be known. Therefore, I created the creation and I created you.
Yine Kur'an'dan da eğer ayet gibi yansıyorsa, kul in istaizu billah kul in kuntum tuhibbunallaha fattabi'uni yuhibbukumullahu ve yaghfir lakum zunubakum wallahu gafurur rahim buyurmaktadır. Yani söyle Habibim Muhammed sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem, eğer beni seviyorlarsa sana tabi olsunlar. Muhabbetle başladığının delail ve berahini okumuş olduğumuz ayetle de zahirdir.
And again in the Divine Quran it is said that O Muhammed, may God's peace and blessing be upon you, if they wish to love me, that they should obey you and they should love you. Those are proofs that Islam is a religion of love, of God's love upon people, and people's creation is to love God.
Allah'ın sevgisi olmasaydı mahlukatı halk etmeyeceğini ve yine levlâke levlâk lemâ halaktul eflâk, yani seni halk etmeseydim felekiyatı, mahlukatı, dünyayı ve semavatı ve ardı yaratmayacaktım demesi, bunun apaşkar gün gibi bir delilidir ve bürhanıdır ve şahididir.
If the creative force which is responsible for the creation did not have as nucleus the love of the divine, it is indeed evident of what I have just quoted you, that the creation would not have been created and the prophet would not have appeared.
Yine ehli hakikatin beyanı üzerine sahabeden birisi Hazreti Peygamber'e, ya Resulallah, ne vakitten beri nebisiniz diye sorduğunda Efendimiz, Adem henüz toprak ile su arasında iken çamuru yoğrulmadan ben nebiydim. Yine çamur ve su halk olmadan da ben nebiydim buyurmuşlardır.
And when one of the companions of the prophet asked the prophet, may God's peace and blessing be upon him, when did you become a prophet? The prophet's answer was that I was a prophet before Adam was between earth and water. And in fact, I was a prophet before water and earth was created.
Ve haberlerde şöyle gelmiştir. Ehli hakikat şöyle haber vermiştir. Allah-u Zülcelal ve Tekaddes Hazretleri bu mahlukatı halk edeceği vakitte, yani mahlukatın halk ettirilmesi kendine, kendinden sevdirildiği anda, kendi nurundan bir nur halk ederek kün Muhammed'e Muhammed ol demiş ve halk olunan nur Cenab-ı Hakk'ın zatını tevhid etmiştir. La ilahe illallah demiştir.
When God loved to be known, that treasure which is God be known, and started his creation, he first created a light, a divine light, and said, be Muhammad, become Muhammad, and that light, which is the light of Muhammad, was created. And then as soon as the light of Muhammad was created, he started reciting the Tawhid, the declaration of unity, La ilahe illallah.
Cenab-ı Hak da Habibinin nurunun bu tevhidine mukabil Muhammedur Resulullah diyerek onun risaletini tasdik etmiş ve mühürlemiştir.
And when this divine sound of the first creation, the light of Muhammad, came to be, which declared the unity of the Creator, God responded, thus confirming the prophethood of Muhammad's light by saying, Muhammad Rasulullah, that Muhammad is my messenger.
Hatta şair şu kelimeyle ne kadar güzel bu İslam'daki aşkı ve muhabbeti ve muhabbetin tamının Hazreti Peygamber'de olduğunu isaret etmekte. Muhammed'den muhabbet oldu hasıl, Muhammed'siz muhabbetten ne hasıl buyurmaktadır.
How beautifully the poet declares that the love came out from the Prophet, and love without the Prophet is of no use.
Bu sözümüz bizim, bana birisi derse ki bu sözün senin bir kavli mücerrettir, yani ispatı nedir diye sorarsa, bunun canlı ispatı gözümüzün önündedir.
If somebody would ask us the question, what is the proof of this declaration? The proof of that declaration is right in front of our eyes.
Bugüne kadar milyonlarca İslam'dan aşık gelmiş, Allah'ı seven ve Allah'a aşık olan kutüpler, veliler ve şayih ve ehli tarik zamanımıza kadar gelmiştir. Ve aynı zamanda da yine avam-ı nas'tan olan zevat bile İslam'ın bir binası ve rüknü olan Kâbetullah'ı ve Resulullah'ın kabrini ziyaret aşkıyla dünyanın her tarafından her sene milyonlarca insan malını, canını, evladı, ayalini, her şeyini terk ederek Resulullah'ın kabrini ziyarete gider. Bu da bizim sözümüzün İslam'da aşkın ve muhabbetin olduğunun bir delilidir.
One proof is the existence of millions of saints, of lovers, of teachers, which came in the 1400 years of the known Islam. But another proof is an ordinary one, and which happens every year when millions of Muslims, they go to the Kaaba for their pilgrimage, and their travels, which Mr. Hixon was with us this year, is a proof of this fact, because it's an extremely difficult travel, and without the love of God, and without men's love for each other, and without men's love for the creation of God, nothing and nobody could force one into such a travel.
Şunu da esefle söylerim ki, hiçbir dinden bu kadar kendi peygamberine bağlı olarak, her şeyini bırakarak peygamberini ziyarete giden hiçbir kavim yoktur dünyada.
I may also add this, that neither today nor in the history which I have come to know have I seen such love for God and such love for the Prophet of God which would induce one to take such undertakings and such sufferings.
Ve Cenab-ı Peygamber'in bir ismi de Habibullah'tır, Allah'ın sevgilisidir.
One of the attributes and names of the Prophet, may God's peace and blessings be upon him, is the beloved of God.
Ve gene bu hususta Kur'an'ın ilanı vardır. Ve men yuteyir rasul fakat ata Allah. Benim Resulüme kim itaat ederse bana itaat etmiş olur. Benim Resulümü kim severse beni sevmiş olur. İnnellezine yubayuneke innema yubayunallah ayeti bunun apaşkar delilidir. Sana biat eden Habibim bana biat etmiştir. Buyurulmaktadır.
The three verses which I have quoted from the Quran, which could be translated into English as whoever obeys you, obeys me. Whoever loves you, loves me. Whoever holds unto you, holds unto me.
İslam sufilerinin yazdıkları kitaplar ortadadır, meydandadır. İsteyen bunları tedrik edebilir. Bütün aşkullah ve muhabbetullah ile dolu.
All the books written on Islamic mysticism, Sufism, and fortunately many of them now being translated into English, if read, would show the truth of these statements which are being made tonight, that the whole essence of these books, the whole path of these books, the whole method of these books are based on love.
Ve eshaftan Resulü sallallahu aleyhi ve selleme aşık olanlar vardır.
amongst the first companions, we see the best proof of this love to the Prophet.
Ve aynı zamanda işte Resulullah'a aşık olan bu eshabın varisleri de günümüze kadar gelmiştir. Bugün milyonlarca insan Muhammed aşkıyla kavrulmaktadır.
The inheritors of these early companions are the sheikhs of today. And today, millions of people, their hearts are aflame and their beings are being burnt by the love of the Prophet and of God and of the creation of God, which are his attributes.
Aşk, Allah'ın sıfatlarından bir sıfattır.
God is one of the attributes of God. Love is one of the attributes of God.
Hatta Hakk'ın kendisine de aşk diyebiliriz.
In fact, we can call the truth, the divine truth, God. Simply, we can call him with the name love.
İslam'da aşk yok, muhabbet yok diyenler güneşe balçıkla savmaya kalkanlardır.
The ones who think that there is no love and compassion in Islam are like those who are trying to smear mud on the sun.
Bunca yapılan camiler, bunca yapılan mücadeleler, bunca yapılan beldeler ve yapılan imaretler ve hastahaneler ve yapılan hayır hasenat Allah'a olan aşkın bir nişanesi değil midir?
The Islamic history is full of actions, of good deeds, building of institutions for the benefit of humankind, the advancement of sciences and of philosophies and of ethics and morals. For those who do care to read about those, it would become evident to them the influence and the essence which is love in Islam.
Yine Kur'an'dan eşeddu hubben lillah, Allah'ı şiddetle severler diye ehli İslam'ı Allah'ın met ve sena etmesi Kur'an-ı Kerim'de bu aşka ve muhabbete bir delil değil midir?
In the Holy Quran, there are often the mentioning of
Allah'ı şiddetle severler.
The very strong love, almost an aggressive love for God.
Kur'an-ı Kerim'i tetiği giden ve Kur'an-ı Kerim zaten nida etmekte ve kendisine halkı davet etmektir. Beni niye okumuyorlar? Benimle niçin tefekkür etmiyorlar? Beni niçin tetiği etmiyorlar diyor.
The Quran shouts, chants, why don't you read me? Why don't you study me? Why don't you learn the ways of God from me? The ones who would read that holy book would find the confirmation of all what is said tonight.
İslam'da aşk yalnız kelimeyle değil, ef'alle ishar olunur.
Love in Islam is not just in words. It is expressed in actions.
Ve bu aşk yoluna milyonlarca insan kendini feda etmemiş midir?
And millions of people have sacrificed themselves for the path of love.
Tarihler bunu haber vermekte ve ilan etmekte. Tarihleri karıştırsın okusunlar. Aşk meselesinde İslam'da aşk yok diyenler.
History is a proof to that.
Evet, bir kısa anlatayım kendilerine. Sahabeden birisi günden güne sararıyor ve soluyordu. İsmi Sevvan idi yahut Şuban idi. Ya Sevvan yahut Şuban. Hatırımda kaldığına göre şimdiki hali hazırda ansızın sorulduğu için böyle cevap verebileceğim. Efendim, bu Sevvan her gün yemeden içmeden kesilmiş, yüzü sararmış ve zayıflamıştı, zayıf düşmüştü.
Somebody by the name of Sevvan, one of the early companions of the Prophet, may God's peace and blessing be upon him, stopped eating and drinking and sleeping and started losing strength and becoming paler every day.
Efendimiz Hazreti Muhammed sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem buna sordu. Sevvan, sen günden güne erimektesin. Senin derdin nedir?
And our master asked Sevvan, what was ailing him? Why was he losing strength and becoming thinner and seemingly unhealthy day by day?
Bu anlattığım kıssa milyonlarca hadisattan bir tanesidir. Yani deryadan bir kadere, şemsten bir zerredir.
This is a story which represents one of a million cases, an atom from the sunshine, a drop from the ocean.
Efendimiz böyle kendisine bu soruyla teveccüh ettiği vakitte bu soruyu, Sevvan birdenbire boşandı ve ağlıyordu, göğsü su içinde kalmıştı ve şöyle cevap verdi, dedi, ya Resulallah biz günahkar insanlarız, sen Allah'ın habibisin, sevgilisin, elbette yarın mahşer gününde hepimiz aynı derecede olamayız. Biz seni dünyada bir gün görmesek, bir saat görmesek dayanamıyoruz. Sen bizim için içtiğimiz su, aldığımız hava, yediğimiz yemek gibisin. Sensiz yaşayamıyoruz. Ama bu böyle dünyada böyle oluyor. Ya ahirette derecatımız ayrı olacak. Sen bir peygamberi zişansın, Allah'ın sevgilisisin. Yüce bir makama nail olacaksın. Biz senden ayrı düşersek bizim halimiz nice olur. Bunu düşünerek yemeden içmeden kesildim.
Sevban, in response to the question of the Prophet and in response of this kind care which the Prophet showed to his companion, answered, O Prophet, you are the chosen one of God. You are sinless. You are the beloved of God. While we are sinners, we are lowly. We cannot stand a minute without seeing your beautiful face in this world. What is going to become of us in the hereafter? Your station will be elsewhere, in a high level, in paradise. How are we ever going to see you? That is my suffering, and that is why I am wasting away.
Efendimiz buyurdular ki, ey Sevvan, niçin üzülüyorsun? Kişi sevdiğiyle beraberdir.
And the Prophet, may God's peace and blessing be upon him, said, O Sevban, don't worry, because one is together with the one whom one loves.
Sen de benimle berabersin.
You will be with me there as well as here.
Ben Nebiyim, Resulüm, sen benim ümmetimsin. Madem ki beni seviyorsun, Allah ahirette seni benimle ayırmayacak. Kişi sevdiğiyle beraber, sen de benimle beraber olacaksın dedi. Bu müjdeyi verdi ki buna hepimiz bunu bekliyorduk, bu cevabı. Ve şad olduk diyor Ashab-ı Kiram.
When the companions heard this response, that the one who loves will always be together with the one whom he loves, that became the greatest news, the thing which made them most happy in their lives.
Ben bir Müslümanım ve müminim. Aşkı ve muhabbeti Hazreti Muhammed'in taliminden aldım.
I am a believer and I am a Muslim. The only thing which I know about love, I have learned from my Prophet.
Eğer peygamber bana aşkı sunmasaydı, Allah bana aşkı ihsan etmeseydi, nasıl Allah'a ve Resulünü sevebilirdim?
If the Prophet would not have taught me, and if I would not have felt this strong feeling of love coming from God, how could I have loved God and believed in Him, and how could I have loved the Prophet and believed in Him?
Yani kendimi ortaya koymamından maksat kendime bir paye vermek değildir. İslam'da aşk ve muhabbet yok diyenlere canlı bir delili de fakirdir yani.
I am not putting myself as an example, but just as one of the millions who are afflicted of the same love, I am showing myself as a living example, a humble living example.
Yine sahabeden birisi bir gün mescide geldi ve Cenab-ı Peygamber'e şu soruyu sordu. Ya Resulallah, mete sa'a, kıyamet ne vakit kopacaktır dedi.
And again, one of the early companions came and asked the Prophet, when is the doomsday, when will be the day of last judgment?
Efendimiz sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem, namaza durdular.
Our Prophet, without answering that question, started making his prayers.
Ve namazdan farig oldular.
And when he finished his prayers,
ve yüzünü cemaate döndüler.
He turned his face to his companions.
Ve onlara, oradaki bulunan cemaate şöyle hitap etti. Mete sailu, nerede o sail, soru soran, nerede o soru soran?
and ask, who was the one who asked that question?
فَقَامَ الرَّجُلُ اُزَاتْ اَيَا قَلْقْتِ Suali soran benim ya Resulallah. Kıyamet ne vakit kopacak dedim.
And that person stood up and said, I am the one who asked the question. When is the last day of this world? When is the day of last judgment?
Efendimiz ona cevaben dedi ki, kıyamet bir emri mühimdir, olacaktır.
To that the Prophet responded, the last day of judgment is an order of God, and it is going to certainly happen.
Ama bu evvel olur, sonra olur, yakında olur, uzakta olur, mutlaka olacaktır.
It may be soon, it may be later, but certainly it will happen.
Zira bir bina yapıldığı vakitte o bina mutlaka yıkılır.
Because all what is built is going to be destroyed.
Doğan ölür.
All who are born are going to die.
Toplanan cemaat dağılır.
Everything which is gathered are going to be scattered.
Her şeyin bir nihayeti vardır.
Everything has an end.
Yalnız nihayeti olmayan ebed ve ezel Allah'tır.
The only entity which has no before, no after, who is eternal, who has no end, is God.
Kıyametin kopacağı saati öğrenmekten gayen nedir? Bunu öğrenip ne yapacaksın? Ama sen kıyamet gününü için ne hazırladın? Dediler.
And the Prophet asked to the petitioner, he said, what is it to you when the doomsday is? When is the day of last judgment? What is important is what you have prepared for that day.
O zat cevaben, Resulullah'a cevaben dedi ki, ya Resulallah, vallahi benim uzun uzun ibadetlerim yok, uzun uzun oruçlarım yok, namazım yok. Ama işte Allah'ın emrini yerine getirmeye çalışan bir insanım. Beş vakit namazımı kılarım, senede bir ay orucumu tutarım. Ve Allah bana bir şey verirse bir nafaka, onun bir miktarını yoksullara dağıtırım. Ve ömrümde bir defa belki hac yaptım yahut yapacağım. Başka bir ibadetim yok, böyle uzun uzun ibadetlerim. Ama şunu söyleyeyim ki, Allah'ı ve seni çok severim.
And the one who asked the question said, O Prophet, I have lots of sins and not many good deeds. I have barely been able to follow my strict obligations that I do my 5 times prayer a day, that I fast during the month of Ramadan. Then when I have money, I give it as alms, and perhaps once in my lifetime I will perform my pilgrimage. But I am a sinner, and my good deeds are less. But I love you very much, to the Prophet he said, and I love God very much.
Öyle deyince, Cenab-ı Peygamber sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem buyurdu ki, ey Arabi, kişi sevdiğiyle beraberdir.
To that the Prophet responded, O Arab, the one who loves is together with the one whom he loves.
Sen de benimle berabersin.
And you are with me.
Anlaşılıyor ki bu hadiseden Resulullah'a layık olmak, Allah'a layık olmak, Allah'ı sevmek ibadetle değil demek ki. Peygamberle beraber olmak. İbadetle değil, muhabbetle, aşkla. İşte aşkı talim ediyor apaşka.
With this hadith, we understand that prayer, devotion, and doing one's religious duties is not the sole way to reach God. And in fact, perhaps it is insufficient. The path is the path of love. The path is the path of the love of God and the love of His Prophet.
Aşkı ispat etmekte ve Allah'la buluşmak ve Allah'ı sevmekle, Resulullah'la buluşmak, peygamberle buluşmak, Resulü sevmekle, ibadetle değil. Bu anlaşılmakta burada. Yani İslam'da aşkın olduğunu apaşikar gün gibi ishar etmekte bu hadise.
To find God is only possible through love. To find and understand His Prophet is only possible through love of the Prophet and of God.
Eğer bir mümin Allah'ı sevmezse beş vakit, gününün beş vakitini her şeyini bırakarak, huzura çıkarak Allah'a hesap verir mi?
And indeed, if a believer would not love God and would not love his Prophet, would he leave everything at hand and present himself in front of God five times a day to do his ritual prayers?
Ve geçen birkaç sene evvel zannediyorum bir mecmuada okudum. Dünyada istatistik yaptılar. Hangi isim çok anılıyor diye.
I have read a few years ago in a magazine, a statistics. Which name is the one which is being remembered and which is being given to children most often?
Ve şuna karar verildi ki dünyada her gün en çok aranan isim Muhammed ismidir.
And I have read that every day the name which is mentioned most and which is given most is the name of Muhammad.
Muhammed. Kişi sevdiğini çok zikreder.
The one who loves, remembers and calls and speaks the name of the beloved often.
İşte Resulü sevildiğini ve İslam'da aşkın olduğuna da bu da bir delildir.
Here is even a statistical proof to the fact that Islam is a religion of love and the Prophet of Islam is a symbol of love and the Prophet of Islam is beloved by his followers.
Yine bir kısa da anlatacağım, hatırıma geldi şimdi. Bir talebe hocasına, çok alim olan bir hocasına, siz niçin peygamberliğinizi ilan etmiyorsunuz dedi.
This is a story. A student once asked his teacher, who was extremely knowledgeable, extremely wise, why didn't the teacher declare his prophethood?
Hocası dedi ki ona, ya öyle doğru söylüyorsun dedi. Şu testiyi al da dedi, şuradan dedi, dereden, pınardan bana bir testi su getir dedi.
And the teacher said, indeed, you must have something in your question. Why don't you take this pitcher and go and fill it up in such and such fountain?
Talebesi dedi ki hocasına, efendim dedi, su alayım ama şimdiki kış gecesiydi, zemhereydi, çok soğuk vardı dışarıda, kar yağıyordu. Şiddetli bir soğuk ve fırtına vardı. Dedi ki hocam alayım ama dedi dışarıda şimdi canavarlar vardır suyun başında dedi. Yani kurt hayvanı çıkar, canavar çıkar dedi. Onun için yani benim canıma bir zarar gelebilir dedi.
So the student said, because that was a night of blizzard in the middle of winter, said, oh master, I would willingly go and fetch water. But you see the state of affairs outside. There is a blizzard, everything is frozen, and it is snowing. Perchance there would be wolves and animals around that fountain, and perchance it would be frozen.
Hoca biraz daha konuştuktan sonra gene dedi ki, oğlum benim canım çok soğuk su istedi. Şu testiyi al, pınara git. Bana pınardan su al da gel dedi.
The teacher spoke some more. And again asked the student, said that I really would like to have some fresh water. Why don't you take this pitcher, go to the fountain and fetch me some fresh water?
Talebe dedi ki, hocam dedi, söyledim ya az evvel, suyun başında şimdi canavarlar bulunur ve havada çok soğuktur. Ben dışarı çıkarsam şimdi helak olurum dedi.
And the student responded again, oh my master, I told you before, look at the state of affairs outside. It's freezing. There is a blizzard. And all the wolves and wild animals would be out tonight. That it would mean my destruction if I would go out.
Yine dersi okudular biraz daha. Yine hoca tekrar etti çocuğa. Dedi ki aradan bir iki saat geçti. Oğlum çok suya susadım dedi. Hararetlendim. Bana lütfen şu testiyle git. Pınardan bana su getir dedi.
And the master continued his teaching, and after a while repeated his request to the same student and asked him to go and fetch some fresh water from the fountain outside.
Hocanın bu teklifi çocuğu irşattı ama talebe bir türlü kavrayamıyordu işi.
Indeed, this proposition of the teacher was perhaps the most important part of the teaching of that day, but the student refused to understand.
Bir müddet sonra minarelerde başladı Allahu Ekber, eşhedü enne Muhammed Resulullah deyip müezzinler bağırmaya.
After a while, they heard the call of prayer, of the morning prayer, that in the minarets, the muezzins were chanting the call to prayer.
Dedi ki, evladım bak dedi, görüyor musun? Benim hayatımdayken benim yanımda sen suyu alıp bana getirmedin içirmek için. Hazreti Muhammed ahirete gideli şunca sene oldu, bu kadar sene oldu. Bir gün ezan ne soğuk, ne sıcak, ne harp, ne darp, ne açlık, ne hastalık demedi, minarelerde ezan okundu dedi. Bak gene ezan okunuyor dedi. Bu zamat aşkı olmasaydı kalkıp da şimdi Hazreti Peygamber'in ismini anmak için minareyi bu havada çıkar mıydı? Helak olmayı düşünmez miydi dedi. Ha, öyleyse peygamber dedi, peygambere olan muhabbet ve aşk senin bana söylediğin gibi peygamberi ilan etmekle olmaz bu iş dedi. Bu Allah vergisidir dedi. İslam'daki olan aşktır bu dedi.
And at the sound of the call to prayer, which mentions the name of the Prophet, the teacher said to his student, my student, he said, don't you hear what is being said? Whether it is hot of the day, whether it is blizzard, or whether it is cold, for all these thousands of years, for the love of Muhammad, these people climb up to the minaret and they chant God's name, and in accompaniment to God's name, they mention the name of his prophet. You see, I am alive, and I am your teacher, and you may think that I am wise, and that I have got many things, but one does not become a prophet with knowledge, but one becomes a prophet with the love of one's people and the love of one's God.
Sayılmayacak kadar yapılan bu fedakarlıklar Allah aşkından değil midir? İnkar mı edeceğiz yani?
All these sacrifices which the Muslims do, whether it is hot or cold, whether they are sick or healthy, whether they are young or old, aren't they a sufficient proof for the love which they feel for their prophet, and for the love which they feel for God, and for the love which they feel for the creation where they see the manifestations of God?
Sabahlara kadar ağlayan aşkan vardır Allah aşkıyla.
There are lovers who spend their nights shedding tears with the love of God.
Ve bu aşıklar gözyaşlarını kimseye göstermek istemezler.
But those lovers do not show their tears to others.
Bu muhabbet Allah'la benim aramda kalsın için.
Because that's a secret love between them and God and his prophet.
Biz sohbetin başına gelelim.
Let's come back to the beginning of our conversation.
Allah nuru Muhammed'den,
from the light of Muhammad, which is the first creation of God,
arşı,
God has created the throne of God,
kürsiyi, cenneti ve cehennemi ve melaikeyi halketti.
God has created the throne of God, the realm of God, hell, paradise, and the angels.
Ve Hazreti Adem'i halketti.
And God has created Adam from the light of Muhammad.
Ve Adem'in alnına Hazreti Muhammed'in nurunu koydu.
And God has placed to the forehead of Adam the light of Muhammad.
Ve meleklere emretti ki, estağfirullah, ve iskulna lil melaiketi iscudu li Adem fesecedu illa iblis. Ey melekler, Adem'e secde ediniz. Çünkü onun alnında nuru Muhammed var dedi.
And he ordered all the angels to prostrate in front of Adam, because Adam carried the seal of the light of Prophet on his forehead.
Ve Adem'e secde edildi.
All the angels obeyed and prostrated in front of Adam.
Cennet ve cehennem, arş ve kürsi ve levh ve kalem cümlesi Allah'ın aşkıyla ve aşkından halkolundu.
With the exception of the devil.
O da nur-u Muhammed'di sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem.
All and everything is created from this single source, from this first creation of God, the light of Muhammed.
Adem aleyhisselam asi oldu ve cennetten çıkarıldı. Yani zelle sadir oldu, cennetten çıkarıldı. 300 sene ağladı affı için. 300 sene sonra
Cenab-ı Hakk'a dedi ki, Ya Rabbi, alnımda olan Nur-u Muhammed hürmetine beni affet dedi. Ve Adem Aleyhisselam'a Cenab-ı Hak şöyle buyurdu. Dedi ki, nereden bildin benim indimde Muhammed'in kıymetini? Buyurdu ki, Adem Aleyhisselam bana can verdiğim vakitte, ben gözüm açtım, nereye baktımsa senin isminle Muhammed'in ismini gördüm sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem. Onun hürmetini istedim. O vakit Adem'in de suçu ve günahı affoldu. Allah şöyle ahd-i peyman eyledi. Her kim ki bana dua eder, benim Habibim olan, sevgilim olan Muhammed'imin ismini zikrederse duasında, duasını reddetmen, kabul ederim dedi.
And Adam requested love in paradise. And God said to Adam that love necessitates tears. Love necessitates sufferings. And paradise is not a place for love and suffering. And that was the reason why Adam had to go out of heaven. But when Adam left the paradise, he cried and lamented for 300 years. And at the end of 300 years, God forgave Adam for the sake of the seal of the light of Prophet on his forehead.
These are the words of Shaykh Muzaffer from Istanbul, who is called Ashki. His name as a poet means the one who belongs to love. And when asking him why Pir Nuruddin Jerrahi, the founder of his order, the great saint of the 17th century in Turkey, came, Shaykh Muzaffer answered simply, for love, for love, for love.
Thank you.
This is Lex Hixon again, wishing you a peaceful, joyous evening.